Hello, in this video I will explain main parameters which you can find using ChatGPT or developing your own LLM. Do you know what does it mean these parameters? Max new tokens, sample top key, sample top P, and temperature. By playing with these parameters, you can adjust how the LLM behaves. Also, you will learn what is greedy and random sampling while generating LLM output. So, all these parameters called inference configuration parameters. They influence the way that the model makes the final decision about next word generation. This is what the coder part is doing in attention architecture. Keep in mind, these are different than the training parameters which are learned during training time. Instead, these configuration parameters are invoked at the inference time and gives you control resulting in output such as the maximum number of tokens in the completion and how creative the output is. Before explanation, I recommend to remember attention mechanism architecture, and with this context, the softmax layer is that which is responsible for the output we get from our prompts. As it goes after linear layer, softmax calculating probabilities for the every next token in attention output. And these probabilities can differ based on configuration parameters we set up. Max new tokens is probably the simplest of these parameters, and you can use it to limit the number of tokens that the model will generate. You can think of this as putting a cap on the number of times the model will go through the selection process. For example, if you set max new tokens to 100, the top number of generated output is 100 or less tokens. The same logic valid for higher number of max new tokens, for example 150. But note how the length of the completion in the example for 200 is shorter. This is because another step condition was reached, such as the model predicting end of sequence token. Remember, it is the maximum number of new tokens, not a hard number of new tokens generated. We can talk now about greedy and random sampling. Let's start from greedy sampling. For this example, let's have some random possible outputs with its probabilities. Imagine that this is a list that carries on the complete dictionary. Apartments, flat, house, and hotel. And their probabilities on the right. Remember, the output of the transformer softmax layer is a probability distribution across the entire dictionary of words that the model uses. Most LLMs by default operate with greedy decoding. This is the simplest form of next word prediction, where the model will always choose the word with the highest probability. In our example, that word is apartments. This method works very well for short generations, but is susceptible to repeat words or sequences of words. If you want to generate text that is more natural, more creative, and avoids repeating words, you need to use some other controls. For this reason, random sampling is a good choice. Random sampling is easiest way to introduce some variability. Instead of selecting the most probable word every time, with random sampling, the model chooses an output word at random using the probability distribution to weight the selection. Here, there is a 20% chance that apartments will be selected, but house was selected. Again, apartments has 20% probability, which is maximum, but house was selected with probability of 3%. With random sampling, this equates to a 3% chance that this word will be selected. Overall, by using random this sampling technique, we reduce the likelihood that words will be repeated. However, depending on the setting, there is a possibility that the output may be too creative, producing words that cause the generation to wander off into topics or words that just don't make sense. And that is not good. So, let's explore two settings, top key and top P sampling techniques to help limit the random sampling and increase the chance that the output will be sensible. Let's start from top key. This sampling method selects an output from the top key results after applying random weighted strategy using probabilities. With top key, we can control some variability as this setting instructs the model to choose from only the key tokens with the highest probability. In this example, here key is set to 3, so we are restricting the model to choose from these 3 options. The model then selects from these options using the probability weighting, and in this case, it chooses flat as the next word. This method can help the model have some randomness while preventing the selection of highly improbable completion words. Alternatively, you can use the top P setting to limit the random sampling to the predictions whose combined probabilities do not exceed P. For example, you set P equal to 0.3, then the scope will cover 2 words in this example, apartments and flat. The sum of probabilities of these 2 words is equal or less than top P we set up. 0.2 from apartments plus 0.1 from flat is equal or less than 0.3. Then the model randomly chooses 1 word or token from the scope. In this example, word flat with 10% of probability. So, by summarizing top key and top P, we can highlight the following differences. Top key: select maximum number of tokens to randomly choose from. And top P: select maximum total probability the model choose from. Okay, let's discuss now about temperature and what kind of impact temperature makes to the output. With temperature, you can control randomness. But how? Let's dive in. This parameter influences the shape of probability distribution that the model calculates for the next token. Broadly speaking, the higher the temperature, the higher the randomness. And the lower the temperature, the lower the randomness. The temperature value is a scaling factor that's applied within the final softmax layer of the model that impacts the shape of the probability distribution of the next token. In contrast to the top key and top P parameters, changing the temperature alters the prediction that the model will make. If you choose a low value of temperature, for example, less than 1, the resulting probability distribution from the softmax layer is more strongly peaked, with the probability being concentrated in a smaller number of words. You can see this here in the light green beside the table, which shows a probability chart turned on the side. Most of the probability here is concentrated on the word house. The model will select from this distribution using random sampling, and the resulting text will be less random, and the second will be more closely follow the most likely word sequences that the model learned during training. So, the main takeaway from the low temperature is strongly peaked probability distribution, so less random output text. What about high temperature, let's say higher than 1? Here are pink bars showing the probabilities, and as you can see, with higher temperature, the model will calculate a broader, flatter probability distribution for the next token. Notice that in contrast to the green bars, the probability is more evenly spread across the tokens. This leads the model to generate text with a higher degree of randomness with higher temperature. This can help you generate text that sounds more creative. If you leave the temperature value equal to 1, this will leave the softmax function as default and the unaltered probability distribution will be used. Thank you for watching this and see you on the next video.